Bojo Ani, Talitha Nindijinakaz, Brampton Ndunjaba. Hello, my name is Talitha, and I'm a proud Métis woman. Last month, a Canadian icon passed away at 53 years of age. His name was Gord Downie. Over the past year, I had the incredible privilege to spend time with Gord, his family, and the Wenjack family. We shared moments of laughter and tears. We walked multiple WE Day stages and shared dreams of Canada's future. During his final months, Gord focused on what he loved the most, his art, and he focused his energy on the Downie Wenjack Fund and the Secret Path, sharing the story of Channie Wenjack. Channie Wenjack was a young Indigenous boy who lost his life trying to return home from a residential school in Northern Ontario in 1966. Today, Channie's story and his legacy stands as a monument for the need of reconciliation right here in Canada. Collectively, we have spoken to thousands of people across Canada about the need for reconciliation, and Channie's story, along with the stories of countless others, Gord, his brothers, Mike and Patrick, alongside Channie's family, have poured their hearts into amplifying Channie's legacy. The Downie Wenjack Fund has made massive strides on the path to reconciliation since its inception. Let's take a look at the impact of the Downie Wenjack Fund right now.
Foster relationships between Indigenous and non-Indigenous Canadians by providing safe spaces for dialogue and creating opportunities for these two solitudes to connect. In our first year, the fund has impacted the national conversation on reconciliation in an unprecedented way.
On a secret path, the one that nobody knows, and I'm moving fast.
We've done a lot in only a year, but this is just the beginning. Channie was alone on his journey, but we are not. Do something.
I am the stranger.
We are honored to have members of the Downie family join us today to pay tribute, to tell us some of their own stories and guide us forward on our next steps to reconciliation. Please, everybody in Ottawa, welcome to the stage siblings of our good friend Gord Downie, Mike, Charlene, Paula, and Patrick Downie.
Firstly, thank you. Thank you. We have felt the outpouring and support and love from an entire country. If we can harness even part of that, if we can keep people moving in the direction that Gord started, moving towards reconciliation, we can do something he would be proud of.
Gord taught us all a little something. That this issue is bigger than any of us. He realized along the way that we have a lot to learn from the Indigenous community. We can see the importance of preserving the culture, the language, and the heritage, and also working to right the wrongs of the past.
In the past weeks, we've shared our grief with Canadians, and along the way, we've felt the weight of an entire country. This country weighs a lot, but we've also seen that many hands can make lighter work. There are students planning acts of reconciliation with their friends and classmates. The Downie Wenjack Fund is about the average Canadian caring enough to make a difference in this country. Through his final days, I learned that everything I did for Gord, I learned from Gord. He was a dutiful man, and it's our duty to carry on his legacy and build a path to reconciliation.
5 years ago, Gord and I decided that we were going to try to tell the story of young Channy Wenjack. We hit a lot of roadblocks along the way, but we persevered. 5 years later, Secret Paths has reached a lot of Canadians and got a lot of people in this country talking about these two solitudes. Along with Pearl Wenjack, we created the Downie Wenjack Fund to keep this conversation going, to bring Indigenous and non-Indigenous people together forever. Forever. Now, you should know, we're supporting your teachers, the Downie Wenjack Fund is. We're providing lesson plans around residential schools and reconciliation. And if your school is planning an act of reconciliation, or as we call it, a reconciliation, we want to hear about it. And we want your school to become a Downie Wenjack legacy school. Wouldn't that be great? One that's committed to these acts of reconciliation for years to come. But we're not stopping there. You see, my brother believed that there was something really, really missing in our national identity. And I think we all know what that is. You know, we act like we're a young country, but we're not. We act like we're 150 years old, but we're not. We could reimagine this country of ours as one that taps deep into a 12,000-year-old history. It's right there. We can change who we think we are. We can literally change who we are. So what do you say? Let's do it. Let's build a country. Let's build a country that Indigenous peoples of Canada can be proud of, and let's do it now.
Together with the Wenjack family, we're going to walk along this path that Gord helped clear for all Canadians. And while our family names form the Downie Wenjack Fund, we are all bound together by a greater cause. The Wenjacks carry on Cheney's legacy for the rights and the safety of all Indigenous people. And we are fueled by the hope that Gord had for the future of this country.
Right now, we'd like to introduce you to three more members of our families who are helping us carry on this legacy. Please welcome to the stage our mother, Lorna Downie, along with Chaney's sister, Pearl, and her granddaughter, Sunset.
Right in a line, right across your shoulder.
Bonjour, everybody. It means hello. I'm glad to be here. This is my first time meeting my brothers and sisters and Mama here since Gord's passing. It's been rough. We've gotten Gordon to be our brother. But we've also had the joy of sharing his dreams, of sharing his happiness, of sharing his goals in life. He believed in life. And all of us are wanting to carry that on. And I'm glad everyone here hears us, and that will help us carry Gord's dream. I'd like to bless us all with this song. I think each and every one of us needs the spiritual part of life. My brothers here and sisters here will do the business side of life. But I believe I can do the spiritual side, so will our mom here. And this song is about four colors of people. Four colors of people that we need to blend. There's the black, white, yellow, and red. All my heart must come.
Ladies and gentlemen, can we say a big thank you to Mike, Charlene, Patrick, and Paula, especially Lorna, for joining us today and raising such a compassionate son. Canada owes you a huge debt of gratitude.
And Pearl and Sunset, thank you for joining us today and showing us the power of Cheney's legacy, inspiring not only Gord, but the whole nation to act in reconciliation.
In our time with Gord, we sat and we saw and we spoke to him, and he wanted all Canadians, especially young Canadians, to create a better country. Gord wanted to see a Canada
healed by reconciliation,
grounded in hope and in love and in compassion,
and one that worked together to right the wrongs of the past.
The youth of Canada must carry on this legacy, as Mike so eloquently spoke about.
And as Mike said, the WE organization and the Downie Wenjack Fund created a special partnership this past year focused on reconciliation, offering educational resources so schools and students can learn about reconciliation and how to take action. And we so deeply hope that every single school here today, but every school across Canada, will join in this campaign.
And to the Downie and Wenjack family members, we'd like to present you a humble show of our gratitude, of the gratitude of all the young people here today for what you have done and what you continue to do throughout the country to help support reconciliation.
We have a special gift, a choir that joined us, and a special tribute. But before we bring them out, I'm going to ask all of us to rise one more time and to recognize two families who have become one family with the gratitude of our nation. Thank you.
Thank you.
May we escort you from the stands?
Thank you, Craig.
Can we give them one more big round of applause? Come, keep it going, WE Day. Mike, thank you. Thank you. We can ask you to grab a seat in silence and just take a moment just to recognize how impactful that moment was. We had Gord, of course, here at WE Day Ottawa with us last year, and it's something that hopefully none of us will ever forget. And so, ladies and gentlemen, to perform the song The Stranger from the Secret Path Project, please welcome the OCSB choir and Les Petits Chanteurs de Canada. Can we give them a big round of applause?